Thanks for joining us. I'm Carol Batchelor with your Lake Powell Life News Update for Thursday. Picture perfect weather here in Page in the Lake Powell region. Lovely blue skies, 90 degrees, lows around 60 overnight. The lake very low right now, though. Ramp and route restrictions in place. Closer to home last night, the Page City Council held regular session, during which City Manager Mike Salaya announced that Contour Airlines had settled pending terminal location changes with Phoenix Sky Harbor, which means they could go ahead and approve the city's request for additional service to Las Vegas. Salaya says there would be daily flights continuing to and from Phoenix, but there would also be three flights a week to Vegas beginning in November. Woohoo, let's go. Also, during the council meeting, council members approved the IPM professional service contract for an interim community development director, Jerry Stabley, who was introduced to the city as someone who comes to Page with a wealth of experience in the planning and zoning industry from Pinal, Cochise, and Maricopa County, and that he's a friend and respected colleague of former Page interim city manager Ken Buchanan and current city manager Mike Salaya. The Attorney General warning Arizona residents this morning of a scam that could be making its way across the state. Dozens of people were scammed out of a seafood festival in Phoenix earlier this month. AG Mark Brnovich says he fears more fake events might crop up. The Crab and Lobster Feast was an all-you-can-eat event that led ticket buyers to an empty warehouse and parking lot. Keep an eye out for flyers advertising fantasy race events that so far have been showing up in Tucson, Chandler, and Mesa. The Attorney General reminding consumers to buy tickets from companies they already know and trust. Last night, the Page City Council, during its regular session, awarded an $863,000 bid for John C. Page Memorial Park improvements to Peak Engineering, authorizing them to proceed with the additional park upgrades. Aside from the skate park, which breaks ground next Wednesday, the next phase of work at the park will enhance pedestrian crossings and the parking lot at the community center. A chief hearing officer for the Navajo Nation Office of Hearings and Appeals determined this week that Jonathan Nez remains an eligible candidate for the tribal presidency. Former Navajo Nation presidential candidate Vincent H. Yazzie reportedly filed a grievance in the OHA claiming current Vice President Nez was not qualified to run for the Navajo Nation presidency because of tribal election code violations. Nez was accused of not disclosing a misdemeanor DUI from 2002 on his candidate application. And homecoming week next week, big week of activities here at Page for the Sand Devil students, teachers, and parents, and Sand Devil alumni as well. Page High School Student Council asking you to nominate your favorite Sand Devil alumni to be the alumni king and queen of homecoming. They do need everyone's nominations by this coming Sunday. You can find the details and connect with them to make your nominations on our Facebook page. That's facebook.com/Lake Powell Life News. Thanks for listening to 98.3 and 1340 The Bandit and 93.3 Jack FM. Remember, news, sports, and other information posted on our free website, lakepowellife.com.